I'm struggling with the rule of nines. Can you explain burn coding from an ICD and a CPT perspective? You bet I can. And it is confusing because the terms are kind of interchangeable. Both of them use them, and yet they do them for different reasons. And so it does. It gets a little confusing. This is actually a lot of slides, but several of them are full page pictures. So what you need to know about burn coding for ICD, the questions that you're going to need to know to get the proper code is, where is the burn at? How severe is the burn? The percentage of body area and the cause of the burn. Those are the things you need to know for ICD. For CPT, you need to know the treatment status. So in other words, is this the first time they're being seen type thing. The degree of the burn and the type of treatment that's being given. Now, burns for how severe they are going to be coded from 941 to 946, so you don't have very many codes to choose from. This is going to be first, second, and third degree. If you don't know the difference, it's real simple. First degree, it's just red and painful. It's like, drinking a really hot cup of cocoa and you burn your tongue, or scalding yourself in hot water. Whereas a second degree burn is different. It's quite painful and it's red also, but there's blisters involved, and it actually went down into a lower level of the skin, which is another whole area that I chose not to talk about because there's lots of resources out there. A third degree burn, if we scroll down just a little bit, that's the most severe. That's the one that causes all kinds of problems. It's described as a full thickness skin loss, and that means that it goes through all the layers of the skin. This can even go down into the bone, and it's really actually not painful as the others because it's burned up the nerves. And so but the infection and the healing, it's just a big hot mess. If there's more than one burn present, you always code first the most severe burn. So if you burn if you got a third degree burn on your pinky and a second degree burn on your elbow, the pinky finger is going to go first because it's a third degree burn. Okay, and then as we scroll down, I've got more information that we need to do. And of course, I always start with CPT or ICD because I enjoy ICD more.
Someone's asking a question: does the physician need to state the percentage of the body that is burned, or can the coder use the rule of nines to determine the percentage?
Okay, this is something I did address, or I was going to mention. The physician, it's his job to do the percentage. Okay, and they are taught to do this. Very unlikely are you going to come across a scenario where they don't do this, because this is part of proper documentation, and it's not something they can slip up on. This is a huge part of their documentation. Now, if they don't, I would query the physician. If you can't, and it's up to you, which I don't think it ever should be, then you can use the rule of nines, but your coding manual has the not the rule of nines, a Lund Bowers chart, and I show you a copy of that in these slides. So we'll go over that a little bit more. But don't get wrapped up in, oh, I don't know the rule of nines, because you'll be able to figure out this by how he documents. Go back up, Laureen. I want to show them this example of the woman that was burned. There we go. A 25-year-old presents with a second-degree burn of the right forearm and first-degree burn of the right index finger and third-degree burn of the abdomen. You must sequence your codes as 942.33, third-degree burn of the abdomen, then 943.21, second-degree burn of the forearm, and the 944.11, first-degree burn of the index finger. That's the way that would be sequenced out. And you should only code to the highest level of burn when you assign multiple burns of different degrees and severity in the same body area. So let's say it is the forearm and you have first, second, and third degree burns of the forearm, you would only code third degree, okay, of that body area. But if you have different body areas, then you code them separately with the most severe burn to be listed first. And before you ask, what if you have second degree and second degree? Well, then it just doesn't matter. Okay, so scrolling down, another example. A patient presents with a 10% body surface with third degree burns of the thigh. You assign code 948.11. Here, the fourth digit of the code indicates the total percentage of the body that has been burnt, and the fifth digit indicates the percentage of the body that has received the third degree burn. That's how that code is laid out. Okay. Now we can go down some more. And we'll go through these pretty quick. I don't want to spend a lot of time on the pictures, but I want you to see them. CPT, very simple, guys. There's only a handful of codes that are involved. Initial treatment, first degree burn, when no more than local treatment is required, meaning you just go to the doctor and he treats it, that code is 16000. Then it gets just a little more in depth. Then you have code 16020, dressings and or debridement, initial or subsequent without anesthesia, office or hospital, small. Very simple. Then 16025, dressings and or debridement, initial or subsequent, without an anesthesia, medium. Whole face or whole extremity is your example. Then we jump into 16030, dressings and or debridement, initial or subsequent, without anesthesia, large, like one full extremity. And then scroll down just a little bit more here. I think we got two more, three more. Okay, so that's really all of them for those codings. It's going to be one of those. That's pretty easy. But they do have a few other codes here that you might use eventually, and this is where they go in and cut because the burn is so severe, or they cut away tissue. And there's pictures that I could have put up here, but I didn't. I saved you. I can't say this word very well, but I'm going to pronounce it as escharotomy. I just look at the word and never say it in my head. 16035, and then there's additional to the primary code. All right, now, remember I told you the rule of nines? The rule of nines in your CPT manual has been replaced with a new diagram called the Lund-Browder, not Bauer. I said it wrong earlier. And it again, is just an expanded version of the rule of nines. This is the leading one now. Now, there's others out there. You got the rule of nines, you got the Lund-Browder, you got the Wallace. You know, you've got all these different versions and stuff. But the Lund-Browder is what is in your CPT manual. And it's very simple. I got a little example to show you here. First, let's talk about the rule of nines because that's the basics, okay? And it's not as hard as you think when you look at a diagram. And what it does is it takes the anatomical site and graphics and uses a graphical tool to indicate the total body surface area, or the TBSA, which is an abbreviation you'll see a lot, to divide it up into segments of nine. All right, so one arm's a nine, the other arm's a nine, one leg's a nine, one, you know, or like an 18, 18, and stuff like that. Everything's divisible by nine. The percentages used for each body part are different between adults and children. This is the easiest method to use for adult and children older than 10 years old. Okay, so ultimately, though, what it did was it took anybody over 10 and it lumped them all together. But we know a 10-year-old isn't the same size as a 25-year-old. So that's where the Lund-Browder diagram comes in. It actually is divided up for ages, a whole list of ages, and breaks down those percentages smaller and larger depending on your body size by age. So we scroll down. I think I have a diagram of that. So this is a chart for the rule of nines. So when we have the chest in the or the back, it's going to be 18 because it's, they say 9 and 9, 18. So you get 18 for the front, 18 for the back. You get 4.5 for both arms. You get each leg is 9. So you can see how everything's divided up. That is the basic rule of nines. Everything's divisible by nine. Okay, so now we go to the next chart, which is the adapted chart that Lund Browder, there's the rule of nine for children. So see the difference where each leg is an eight, the chest and trunk's 18. That's the biggest difference. Okay, we can go through that. Actually got these off of firefighters website. It was excellent. And again, a baby. Now, because the baby is so small, see how they even divided it up. The legs, 7 and 7, 18 and 13 for the back. And the head, babies' heads are so big in comparison, they're worth a 9. Okay?
2.5% for each butt cheek.
Butt cheek, I know. I thought that was kind of cute. Now, this is the Lund Browder. This is how this is divided up. So the first one is they do an infant. Now, all this is a rule of nines, but they're not, it's the same concept, except for they're dividing everything up a little smaller. So you got the feet, you got the hands, you got the forearm, and you got the neck, all right? And it's done by age. And if you scroll down a little bit more, it's going to give you, I think, an adolescent or a child, again, age 10 years, 15 years, adult, right? And but see how the half of the head in a 10-year-old is 5.5, 15-year-old 4.5, an adult is 3.5, because it's percentage of the body. So as the bigger you are, the less percentage of the body is involved, right? So quite simple. This is in your CPT manual. I was going to give you the page number because your CPT manuals for each will always be the same. However, to keep this evergreen, every year the page will change. So I didn't want to do that. But that is actually how you do the rule of nines. And we do have additional videos on YouTube for the rule of nines that we've covered before. So I hope with all of this information together that it will help you understand burn coding a little more.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.